All right, guys, today is body shop drop-off day. Just want to review a few things in the car. You've already seen most of it, some of it on Instagram. I have my stock grill back in just to prevent my perfect JDM one from just anything happening to it because they are taking off the front bumper. I was gonna drive to the body shop without either grill installed, but I thought that could be risky with rocks and stuff, and it isn't that big a deal for them to take those out if they needed to. I'll get to that later. I'm in negotiations for a front bumper work too, but I don't know if I'll go ahead with that. It's kind of pricey. Stock hood scoop returned, of course. All three stock bulbs back in on both sides. DRL, turn signal, fog. Just because I don't want my bulbs to get lost, my fancy bulbs, and they're probably going to be taking stuff out. They're removing even the headlights, supposedly, from the estimate. Just unbolting them, so just because all the headlight work's going on, I wanted to get stock everything in there. Of course, I did leave my fogs. That's no big deal. Or, I don't call them fogs, I call them driving lights. That shouldn't be a problem. I probably didn't need to, but I took off my side fender badges in case they need to do any paint blending. And those came off nice, no damage. And in the rear, of course, you know the spoiler is off, the rear emblem is off. I think that's all I did there. I did a little bit of trunk work, just in case there's anything they need to get to here. Whoa, it's like an echo chamber in here. Woo! Beautiful, beautiful dynamat. That is why I don't want to, you know what? Bonus. I want to put a strip down here at some point. Maybe even now, that'll take 3 minutes, and echo more of that bottom noise coming up. It's just one piece I'm missing that probably should have been there. I didn't notice that underneath. And that's about it up there. So I just emptied it out a little bit. Now this is the only side that got dings. The other side did not, just whatever way the hail was going. So I do have along here a bunch of little dings and stuff like that, but I can't see any on this piece here. So they probably don't need to get in here, but you know, just in case. You can see my tail and turns are still there. I love those tailless turns. Everything's exposed. In case they have to take out the lights, they might, because I think they talked about removing the rear bumper too. Not thrilled about it, but that's of course why I took out a bunch of this stuff. Kind of makes stuff a lot easier for them. And of course they are, they're dropping the headliner, which I'm not that worried about. I'm sure they probably do that every day. And, oh, there's a little rag. So, I mean, it isn't like it's anything unusual for them, but, you know, nobody likes having the headliner dropped. It's so perfect, as you can see, and it's might not be quite so perfect when we're done. We'll see what happens. Also concerned about those rear C pillars. Those clips drop all the time, down into nothing land when you try and pop these off. They are going to have to take off those C pillars to drop the headliner. So that's another thing I'm going to check when I get the car back. Might even pull them off when I get the car back and make sure all the clips are there and everything like that. Aside from that, what else? Let me think for a minute. The only thing I really did in this engine compartment, aside from just the stock DRLs back in, I of course removed the big pair and shroud, because they are going to take off the front bumper to do like hood blending and stuff, and that just makes everything much, much easier. So I just took off that front shroud, put that away too. That's really about it. Everything else kind of stock right now. The car is running great. Like, when I had it like this, I mean, not this, but I mean, if it was bone stock looking outside, I think it'd be kind of cool, because it's just such a power plant, and it would look 100% stock if it did. Obviously, I don't have a stock rear spoiler for the trunk or anything, but I just thought it'd be kind of funny to like have a totally bone stock looking WRX and then have this fully bolted stage 2 power under it. But then again, I love the flashiness of my car when it's all done up the way it should be. So, whatever. I'm going to keep it nice when I get it back. Front plate's off, as I mentioned. I had the front plate with me yesterday in case I got pulled over, just to try and get me out of a trouble. But I'm not bringing it today. I'm just going to the body shop as the next drive this car takes, and then nothing else. I will be documenting trip A and trip B meter. Trip B is the trick. Even if someone, not that anybody would ever reset it unless something funky's going on, but if someone did reset the A, then don't forget you have the B, the lesser known hidden one that most people wouldn't think of. And just to check my tenths of the mile and stuff, you know, I have no doubt that nobody's going to go drive this around. But for peace of mind is all it is. I do have all these parts laid out, as you know. I posted a lot of that on Instagram. I have my three sets of bulbs I talked about. Of course, I took off my ovals. This is my rear oval. It came out nice. I didn't actually break it taking it off, which is surprising. My rear custom. The painted fogs. Now, see, they're not cherry, but with the paint area, they are actually cherry. There's no scratches. So I took these off just in case. And my JDM grill down there with the oval still on it, right? Just keeping that all nice. The fender badges also came off real nice. Still look perfect, really. I would have to do more tape if I put these back on. I mean, of course, I will put these back on. That's about it. I got all my bolts taped to various parts, the trunk parts, different things here, just keeping things organized. There was one other thing. Hold on a minute. Oh, yeah. I have fresh some of these coming. They might be the exact same, but just to maybe avoid the, I mean, they were cheap, just to avoid the needing to put new tape on them and stuff. I have a couple more of those coming. Not that these have even one scratch. They don't. They're perfect. And I have a new set of oval badges to try, change up the look a bit. I found something new out there that I kind of wanted in the old days, and it didn't really exist. So I got something on order to show you guys and see if I might change my look a little bit. I do like the tinted Subaru there. See how clean that is for more of the dark look. But there's a different look I might try. It's a nice 3D look, and I'm going to go ahead and let you guys in on that a little bit later. Fan shroud out there. As you know, I have TGV deletes coming again. EGR delete coming again. Grimspeed EBC. Electronic boost, EBCS coming again, and something else from Perrin coming. This is all about a week out. You know, the car is going to be in the shop anyway. But I have quite a few things coming there. I have a new DRL for the Forester coming, a different brand. Remember the ones I had, the same as my car. Remember they were causing a little hum in that car, just because it vibrates more or whatever. And I have a different set of non-fanned DRLs coming from a different company, just to give a shot in the Forester, see if, because the lights were good. I just want to see if the fanless design is a little quieter, things like that. So I do have that coming too. I should have some Detail Pro metal cleaner, what do you call it? Polish, metal polish coming, so I can try some of that new metal polish instead of the Mothers and the Never Dull that I always use. Want to see what that's all about. There might be a couple other things, but I can't think right now. There's too many things I got to keep track of. So I'll probably finish the video showing the odometers, the trip meters, and then we'll see what happens in about a week, week and a half. I'm going to miss my baby a lot.
right to merge onto I-64 towards Suffolk.
Guys, we're at the body shop. Car is dropped off. I'm gonna wait for a rental thing coming up soon. This is the place we're going. It is rated one of the best places in Virginia Beach. I know there's a lot of body shops around here, but I do have good trust in this. These guys did our Forester with the little rear fender mishap also. It came out pretty good. Another WRX there, you can see. They actually get a lot of WRX for this issue. Leaving it, saying goodbye to my baby for a week and a half. I'm gonna really miss it. Waiting to get a crappy rental like a Yugo or something. Do they still even make Yugos? And hope you enjoyed this, and there's gonna be a lot of stuff going on when we get the car back. See ya. Are you guys ready to see the rental? This rental is a car that I thought about buying strongly 2 or 3 years ago when they first came out. It's a car I always wanted to try, and I can't believe I got it. Plus, you know, the insurance covers like, I don't know, $30 a day. This car was only like $32-$33 a day. I couldn't believe it. I thought this would be a $40-$50 a day car. And here it is. The Renegade. Well, it's the Jeep. What is it? Yeah, the Renegade. Now, I think this is the Trailhawk too. Yeah, this is the good one. The Trailhawk with the extra 4x4 things. The only thing I think it's missing is the sunroof. But aside from that, this is the Renegade Trailhawk edition, maximum 4x4. It ain't a Wrangler, of course. It ain't beefy like that. But I always wanted to try this. This probably has, I don't know if it's the 2.4 Tiger Shark or the other engine, the 1.8. I'm gonna find out. And this has an 8-speed automatic. So we will be taking a few cruises in it over the week and learning a little about it, and should be pretty sweet series there. I'll make a fresh series for this called Jeep Renegade. All right, guys, I'll see you, and my car is off to work.